Good morning, Lincoln Lions. This is Mr. Conan. It's your daily announcements for Thursday, May 21st, 2020. Every day, we'll be doing the pledge. Please stand for the pledge. 3, 2, 1. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Next. We'll do Lincoln's spirit on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Lincoln's spirit makes us proud, respectful lions above the crowd. Our spirit makes us try our best and challenges us to encourage the rest. All right, announcements. Students continue to ask questions. This is our last packet. We're turning everything in on the 22nd. So make sure you turn everything in this Friday and then you get your last set of activities for the rest of the year. Can you believe it? We're already down to the last 2 weeks of school. So make sure to turn everything in. Chromebooks get turned in June 5th, but everything else, like your instruments and your homework, anything that packets you've done, get all turned in by Friday so we can make sure we have time to get it scored. All right, there's a reverse parade on June 4th from 6 to 6:45. We'll be advertising more. Drive by the front of the school with signs or just honk and wave and say goodbye to your teachers and to me. Sad. K-5, report card handout by teachers will be June 5th, the last day of school. Kindergartens are asked to come to get their report cards at 8 o'clock. Teachers, your teachers will be handing them out. First grade, 8:30. Second grade, 9 o'clock. Third grade, 9:30. Fourth grade, 10 o'clock. And fifth grade, 10:30. Then at noon on that day, we have a honkin' wave for sixth graders. Sixth graders will be located on 26th Street, all separated and socially distanced, and we'll be celebrating them because it's their last day at Lincoln. Think about that. They've spent 7 years. Many of them have spent 7 years here at Lincoln. Now they're moving on to middle school, either north or east. Teachers, last week's packets are in the gym. They're ready for you to pick up. We'll have a try to have a full staff meeting on Tuesday. I said Monday yesterday. We don't have school Monday. Yay. So Tuesday we'll have a full staff meeting. Be looking for that time coming out probably a Monday. I'll send it out for Tuesday. We move that from Friday too because we have packet pickup on Friday, which is tomorrow. So thanks for being flexible. All right, talent show update. We'll be conducting a virtual talent show online. We're asking all third through sixth graders that have a talent to video it and send it in for submission. You may submit your special talent between May 11th and today by 4 o'clock, which is May 21st. You have had 10 days to get your talent turned in and done. Ms. Gordillo and her fantastic talent team show team will then choose from the video submissions to create this year's Lincoln Lion Talent Show. There are three ways you and your parents can submit your video: email, Facebook Messenger, or Google Drive by sharing it. You can submit to Mrs. Gordillo or myself, and it's easiest to use these addresses. Terry_Gordillo@gfps.k12.mt.us or myself, John_Conan@gfps.k12.mt.us. Three formats that we like to use are YouTube link, .mov file, or a .mp4 file. Thanks for being part of our talent show. All right, going on, we have our next section is our positive warrior section. Our positive warrior section is about John Gordon, who is a motivational speaker, and he definitely is someone that I admire. I love watching his stuff and talking and listening to him on all of his stuff. He's got several books out, and he speaks to large audiences all the time. So being a positive warrior means that you are spreading positivity no matter where you are at. So this week goes out to third graders. They continue to work hard, especially at IXL. They're stepping up the challenge set forth by their teacher, Ms. Moore and Mr. Conan. And we set a challenge for them of 15,000 questions by the end of the week. They continue to have fun and are being positive. So please send me, your teacher, or have your parents post on Facebook your positive warrior acts so we can celebrate them on morning announcements. All right. Today's parenting tip comes from me, Mr. Conan, from the Child Mind Institute. The topic is accept your feelings. So this is for parents. Many of us feel sad, angry, or anxious right now, and we have to acknowledge that. instead of fighting it, allow us to ride out our emotions, and it might even free us up to move on and say, okay, so now what needs to be done? And we can move on from those feelings. So great parenting tip there from the Child Mind Institute. Right, book of the day. Each day we'll be reading a story from a list of Scholastic books that have been approved. Today I have a fabulous guest reader, one of our Lincoln Lions. She's a kindergartner, Macy. She'll be reading The Kissing Hand by Audrey Penn. Then after that, she has some questions for us. Macy, are you ready to read? Here we go.
Hi, my name is Macy. I'm in Mrs. C's class, and I am going to be reading The Kissing Hand by Audrey Penn. Chester Raccoon stood at the edge of the field and cried. I don't want to go to school, he told his mother. I want to stay home with you. I want to play with my friends and play with my toys and read my books and swing on my swing. Please, may I stay home with you? Mrs. Raccoon took Chester by the hand and nuzzled him on the ear. Sometimes we all have to do things we don't want to do, she told him gently, even if they seem strange and scary at first. But you will like school once you start. You'll make new friends and play with new toys, read new books and swing on new swings. Besides, she added, I know a wonderful secret that will make your nights at school seem as warm and cozy as your days at home. Chester wiped away his tears and looked interested. A secret? What kind of secret? A very old secret, said Mrs. Raccoon. I learned it from my mother, and she learned it from home. It's called the kissing hand. The kissing hand asked Chester, what's that? I'll show you. Mrs. Raccoon took Chester's left hand and spread it open his tiny finger into a fan. Leaning forward, she kissed Chester right in the middle of his palm. Chester felt his mother's kiss wash from his hand, up his arm, and into his heart. Even his silky black mask twinkled with a special warmth. Mrs. Raccoon smiled. Now she told Chester, whether you feel lonely and need a little loving from home, just press your hand to your cheek and think, Mama loves you, Mama loves you. And that very kiss will jump to your face and fill you with toasty warm thoughts. He took Chester's hand and carefully wrapped his fingers around the kiss. Now do be careful not to lose it, she teased him. But don't worry, when you open your hand and wish your food, I promise the kiss will stick. Chester loved his kissing hand. Now he knew his mother's love would go with him wherever he went, even to school. That night, Chester stood in front of his school and looked thoughtful. Suddenly, he turned to his mother and grinned. Give me your hand, he told her. Chester took his mother's hand in his own and and folded her large familial fingers into a fan. Next, he leaned forward and kissed the center of her hand. Now you have a kissing hand too, he told her, and with a gentle goodbye and I love you, Chester turned and danced away. Mrs. Raccoon watched Chester scamper across a tree limb and enter school as the hoot owl rang in the new school year. She pressed her left hand to her cheek and smiled. The warmth of Chester's kiss filled her heart with special words. Chester loves you, it sang. Chester loves you. I love you. I have two chimes for you. The first one is, think of a time when you didn't want to do it, but you still did it and it ended up fun. My second challenge for you is to think what helped you do it and where.
Oh, thank you, Macy. You are an amazing young kindergartner. Can you believe she is only a kindergartner? So she had great questions. They're challenges, she said. So she said, think of a time when you had to do something hard or something you didn't want to do, and it ended up being okay in the end. Great question. Think about that and talk to a parent or a guardian or someone in your house. Next question or challenge she had was, think of who helped you succeed during that time that was hard. And who was that? So great, great questions that go with her story. She is an amazing kindergartner. I love hearing her voice. So we're looking for more people that like to read a book on morning announcements. We only have about 10 or 11 days left of school, so we're still looking for some readers. We have about 4 or 5 readers lined up here, but would love to have some more to finish out our year. All right. At the end of each day, we end with a song, and this is for motivation to get you ready for remote learning. If you'd like to nominate a song for morning announcements, please email me or talk with your teacher or have your parents write a comment on this Facebook post. Today's song comes from another Room 1 student. Almost all students in that class chose a song themselves. This student, he chose Sick Boy by the Chainsmokers, another new song I hadn't heard. Luckily, I listened to all these songs first before we play them, but it does have a positive message in it, so please be looking for that positive message. All right, here we go. Go be a positive warrior, and go Lion Pride.
From the east side of America, where we choose pride over character, and we can pick sides, but this is us, this is us, this is. I live on the west side of America, where they spin lies into fairy dust, and we can pick sides, but this is us, this is us, this is. Don't believe the narcissism when everyone projects and expects you to listen to them. Make no mistake, I live in a prison that I built myself, it is my religion. And they say that I am the sick boy, easy to say when you don't take the risk, boy. Welcome to the narcissism, we're united under our indifference. And I'm on the east side of America, when we are sensitized by hysteria, and we can make sides, but this is us, this is us, this is. I live on the west side of America, where they spin lies in the fairy dust, then we can pick sides, but this is us, this is us, this is. I am the sinner.